Corkscrew, I love the name Corkscrew. I thought that was terrific because it's a climb that I've known since I was 15, going up and down there with Charlie Walsh and training with the national team. So I knew the climb well. And I reckon this year's finish with Cadell winning the way he did was phenomenal. It reminded me of when he won his world title in Mendrisio, the way he attacked late, went up the climb and then just pursued it to the finish was sensational.
I tell you what, I've seen Cadell Evans attack a lot of times, and this is one of his most prominent ones now. 150 metres, give this man a round of applause. What a tremendous ride. Cadell Evans hits the line.
Corkscrew worked really well for us, but I didn't want to flog it to death. I want to sort of keep it on the back burner, keep it fresh. So that's why this year, for next year's race, we're moving to the Torrens Hill Road finish at Paracombe, which is a similar difficult climb, but with no descent. So what the idea there is to have a big final like we've done and seen at Corkscrew, but without the descent. So it's sort of flat out from the bottom of the climb for the last 2K to the finish line, and we'll see what happens. But I reckon the Torrens Hill Road Paracombe finish will be really interesting. I suspect that riders like Cadell, who's now confirmed he'll be here, he'll just get to the foot of that thing and it'll be a time trial to the top. And that will see the race completely blow apart, I think. And we might get to the top with maybe half a dozen, but there'll be bits and pieces all over the place. So the idea is, in my view, that riders like that will attack it hard, knowing that there's no descent, knowing that the effort on the climb is do or die. It's everything. And then if you do get to that last left-hander to the finish line, which is only a couple hundred metres around to the little oval of Paracombe, you're going to win the stage.